Champions League is back and Barcelona kicks it off with a 5-goal fest. Let's get to it. Alright guys, welcome back to El Merengue Culé. I hope you're having a fantastic day. The Barcelona game just ended. We got the victory. I'm happy, but I do have some mixed feelings. And you know what? Let's dive straight into it. First of all, let's talk about the way we started. Honestly, I was not happy. The first 10-15 minutes were pretty bad from us. We were getting dominated. The passing was lazy. The defense was lazy. And Koeman implemented a very interesting tactic of having a very high line, which I am all for it. I think this is the perfect scenario, the perfect game to try to implement new tactics. But realistically, those first 10 minutes, Ferencváros was all over us. And of course, minute 10, one of their very fast attackers, Gwen, just takes the ball from half field, dribbles up with speed, and puts the ball in the back of the net. Luckily for us, it was offsides, but it was a wake-up call. The defense was all over the place, and realistically, the defense didn't really improve much throughout the game, which is a big concern on my end. However, as the half progressed, the attack itself definitely got better and better. We started getting more into the rhythm of this new tactical changes that Koeman had implemented into the game, but it still felt like we needed a spark. You know, we were getting close to the goal, but it was a little bit stale, not enough off the ball movement, and what goes and happens, Messi pulls the Messi magic out of the bag, dribbles from half field to the opponent's box, gets brought down, converts the penalty, and honestly, he surprised me. I did not think Messi still had that explosion that he showed. It was great. It was so nice to see, especially right before El Clásico. From here, Barcelona's attack just grew and grew and grew. Trincao looked very comfortable. His dribbling looked good. His shot could have been a little better, but hey, he's young, he's improving, and that's what I like to see. And yes, the 2-0 eventually comes from Ansu Fati. I mean, the Wonder Boy does it again, scores in the Champions League stage. It wasn't the best of finishes, I will admit. I don't think he meant to hit it like that, but it's a goal nonetheless. And can we talk about that beautiful pass from De Jong? I mean, at this point, Barcelona looked very, very comfortable, and the halftime whistle blows. And you know, I was curious, I was like, okay, how will Koeman restart? And I think he had a very good pep talk with the boys. The second half was more of the same. It was just improved. Again, that high pressure from Barcelona with that high line definitely benefited us. We were able to maintain and hold the ball in their attacking third very aggressively, looking for that goal. You know, you felt that third goal was coming. And sure enough, Ansu Fati gets a beautiful assist to Coutinho. Coutinho fakes it like he's gonna shoot to the far post, sneaks it into the near post, and at this point, we are cruising. Barcelona is playing very, very well at this point. The defense is still very shaky. Definitely Lenglet and Piqué were not on the same wavelength at all. The counterattack was still very evident, and at this point, you get the sensation that, okay, this high line is helping us against this type of team, but with the very fast forwards, it is kind of like a double-edged sword. Now, I also want to note that this was a very, very chippy game. From the first minute to the last, we were getting brought down here and there. And at this point, we're cruising, and the last thing we want is injuries or a red card. So, Koeman goes ahead and makes some subs. Minute 60, I was all for it. Takes on Ansu Fati, brings on Dembele, brings on Pedri. I'm all for it. Personally, I would have taken Messi out. I don't want him to risk an injury. And also, look at the schedule we have coming up. We have Real Madrid this weekend. We had Juventus coming up. And just back-to-back-to-back games. You don't want these minutes to keep adding up. At this point, we're cruising. Take him out. Why risk an injury? And just when we thought we were cruising, everything was going well, Piqué goes ahead and picks up a red card. I mean, are you kidding me? Out of all things, a red card. At that point, just let the man score. He had a better chance of scoring if you bring him down and he has a PK, then if he's to score, I mean, yes, it's a one-on-one, but he didn't look that comfortable on the ball. Like, I was very frustrated. Not only did he get a red card and won't be able to play against Juventus, but now you have, what, 35 minutes left in the game, where now the rest of the Barcelona team has to pick up for you getting a red card. They have to run extra. They have to tire themselves out. I mean, it was the worst possible comment. It was it went from the best scenario to possibly one of the worst scenarios we could have been at. And on top of the red card, of course, they go ahead and put the penalty away. Okay, with that being said, honestly, Piqué should have never been in that position. Pjanic, I mean, he should never have given up the ball like that. He just gave him the ball. And realistically, Pjanic had a horrible, horrible, horrible game. And now again, me, very biased, I would have liked to have seen Riqui Puig play, especially in his performance the last few minutes against Getafe. I feel like Riqui Puig should have played. Whatever, that's beyond the point. However, something I do want to note is that the subs, Dembele played much, much better. He definitely felt more comfortable, and you could tell that he gained a lot of confidence. Does beautiful, beautiful dribbling, breaks the defender's back, almost reminded me of Messi breaking Boateng's back, and slides it over to Pedri, and Pedri converts his first ever Barcelona goal. We're right back into the game, or not back into the game, but we're back cruising. We continue to improve on the attack, and we manage to put the 5-1 away. However, 5-1 on paper sounds like a very, very good result, and it is. Don't get me wrong, it is. But that red card really, really sets us back in the long run. I'm very disappointed in Piqué. I feel like he was thinking small picture, right? Oh, I can't let him score. You gotta think of the bigger picture. This red card is gonna hurt us a lot in the long run. With that being said, if you agree with what I said, please hit a big, big, big thumbs up. If you enjoyed the video and wanna see more like these, please hit subscribe and don't forget, turn on the notification bell on, because we are going to be making some El Clasico content that you do not want to miss. Champions League is back. I'm super excited for these games. Thank you for watching. And as always, guys, Visca Barça!